I've been in the studio, I guess, 35 years. I used to teach college, and it became clear to me that the administration and I did not view the world in the same way. Gosh, they fired me pretty regularly. And the last time I said, they said, okay, we made a mistake in firing you, come back. And I said, no, I'm not coming back. And when I got to New York, it became clear that ceramics was not done. And at that stage, you couldn't build a kiln, you couldn't do anything. And so I thought, well, what do people do in New York? Well, they make art. And so I bought a book on art and read it. And 6 months later, I sold a piece to the Whitney. And it was like, it was exciting, but it was like kind of being like a rock star who goes up too fast. And psychologically, I couldn't manage it. So after, I don't know, 2 or 3 years of showing in New York, and you know, that was the 60s, and it was openings with Salvador Dali with a leopard around his neck, and Yoko Ono, and that whole thing. It was just, it was too much for me. So I went to the country and raised chickens to kind of restore my psychological balance. And I've been in that same place ever since. I went back, get up in the morning, and it's like, oh boy, I get to go to the studio. Which is because the process is, these pieces are really evidence of every step that I've gone through. So they're thrown and then fabricated, and so I'm just looking at gray clay to build that shape. And then after that's done, they're painted with white slip, polished, fired once, and then I have this wonderful machine that cuts all of these stencils. And they're adhesive back vinyl that are stuck on and then glazed over, and the vinyl resists. Then they're pit fired. And so it's a dance between control and letting go. I do something, the firing does something, I respond. And then the gold goes on the inside. And I chose gold because these pots really have a subject. They have space inside and decorated surface outside. And the early ones that I were making were black inside, black space. But then I wanted them to open up. And when they opened up, I had surface inside, surface outside, not my subject. So I had to find something inside that behaved like space, and gold does that. And gold, the reason they use it on picture frames is it doesn't actually have a color. It's a material, so it goes with any color. And so I can choose a color gold, and then the last thing I do is the paint. Because in this world, we don't have much control. You know, wives, husbands, dogs, children, the economy, the president, whatever, it's out of control. And so here I get the last word.